The Stevens Brothers Boatyard built some of the finest watercraft the world has ever seen. Their yard was located in Stockton, California, on the Sacramento River Delta, halfway between Sacramento and San Francisco. Thanks to a great friend, Rusty Arreyes, we were able to arrange an interview with Dick Stevens. Dick Stevens is now 98 years old, and the interview took place aboard Rusty's Stevens Motor Launch, Miss 102.
They just have, they have a charisma coming at you on the water. That, where did that come from? Where did that design come from? Was it the hull? Was it Jetson? Was it Whalen? Was it all the above? You?
All the above.
Right.
Team effort.
Well, yeah.
Somebody had an eye there, though, I'll tell you what.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Well, we tried to do it right. And if it was right, it was good.
Yeah.
This is Athena, which is Tapawinga, and the Colonel Ream together.
Yeah, okay. And this is a 50-foot, 55?
Colonel Ream, no, this is the 47-foot.
And that was first Cressy. That was Cressy's boat.
First one, yes.
That was Cressy's boat.
Yeah. I never remember his first.
Okay,
he would have been about 8 years old.
But the second one used to come up.
This is the better.
The shop once a year for work.
Did you know Cressy? Right? Did you know Cressy?
Oh yeah, very well. Rhinestone Joe. He was the character, and couldn't say Tapawinga.
Damn it, Tappa.
You remember the designer of Tapawinga?
Yeah, it was us.
Okay.
George Whalen did most of the design work for us.
Okay.
But he worked for us.
But was he designer or just draftsman?
He did all the design work.
Okay.
But it was under our supervision.
Right.
And he was actually working for us at the time.
So
we think that the flybridge was added. It wasn't on the original.
Did Stevens, do you remember if Stevens tipped that windshield back, or was it?
No.
No, somebody else did it?
No.
Stevens wouldn't do that.
Up we go.
And we have...
Yeah, that's the Colonel Ream bar.
Do you know what the oldest Stevens boat that's still around is? I mean, Queen and Dorothy are gone, right? Queen and Dorothy are gone, as far as we know. What the oldest Stevens boat that's still out there? Would it be one of the runabouts or?
I would say one of the runabouts.
20s, that was early 20s?
Yeah.
Right in there somewhere?
Yeah.
Do you know how the Hagen ended up with the Stevens collection?
When these people that buy our old boats and rebuild them and ask a lot of questions.
Yeah.
you need to pass that off on someone.
That's why I turned it all over to the
museum.
Yeah, that makes sense. Well, you've got a great guy over there, don't you? He's a great guy. He loves you.
He's enthusiastic and
he's a big fan.
And a good guy.
Yeah,
he's a very good guy. Yeah. You're lucky.
He's very nice.
Very nice. Yeah. And he's great.
He's making life interesting for me, he and Rusty.
Well, Rusty plans on keeping you very busy for the next week.
We did our best at the start of the first depression.
Really? Now, why is that?
During the 1920s and 30s, The agriculture industry in this area enjoyed a time of great growth and prosperity. Many of the boats built by the Stevens brothers were built for successful businessmen and farmers.
Right. You said that's when the company did the best financially.
Yeah, that's what I say. That was when we were actually the busiest. Yeah.
That's amazing.
You must have gone through truckloads of lumber per month.
Yes, we did.
Must have had a small lumber yard next to the plant there.
It was a full job.
Did the lumber come on the railroad tracks or did it come by?
It either way.
Yeah, because there's railroad tracks right through the middle of the yard.
Yeah.
I don't remember ever seeing a railroad here when I was born.
Well, we bought the foundry. It was a small foundry and a real good one in Stockton, but but the man's wife died and did the boat. It was just right for us. Three big, huge cabins. This high.
What are those?
We learned from this interview that the Stevens brothers always prided themselves in building and producing a very high quality product. They used the best grades of lumber, non-ferrous fasteners, the highest quality of fittings and hardware, and a top-notch team of designers, artisans, and craftsmen to put them all together. That's why many of their boats have stood the test of time and have lasted so long. Here at the Maritime Preservation Trust, we are dedicated to keeping these vessels as original as possible. They are maritime antiquities, and they are the patterns and the inspiration for designers, builders, and craftsmen of the future.